This is B reading, 8th class, 6th unit, The Earthen Goblet, English. Okay. So, open your textbooks and look into the books. And this is by Harendranath Chattopadhyaya and this is the brother of Sarojini Naidu. Okay. Now, this is the Earthen Goblet. Actually, what is goblet? Goblet is nothing but stem and the glass, just like your ice cream glass, ice cream cup like that. You can see in the picture, okay? That is goblet. Drinking to drink water, we utilize that, just like a glass, okay? And earthen means clay, okay? So, the glass which is having one stem and root and foot, okay? You can see that. And that is made of clay. So, that is earthen goblet, okay? Now, look at the books, all of you. The first stanza I am going to read now. O silent goblet, red from head to heel, how did you feel when you were being twirled upon the potter's wheel before the potter gave you to the world? Okay, so here the poet is asking the goblet about her feelings, about its feelings. Actually, this is personification. Already we discussed this because the earthen goblet has been given a person's feelings. That's why this comes under personification. Okay, now, O silent goblet. This goblet cannot speak, so this is silent. They red from head to heel, so the entire color is of the clay, that is red in color. How did you feel when you were being twirled? Twirled means making round on the wheel of the potter. You can see the picture there. You can see how the potter is making the pots. Okay, even that goblet is also being made by the potter. So when he was doing the the pots and goblets and all, then the potter will twirl the wheel. Twirl means making round and round. Okay. So, like that he was twirling the wheel. Then how this goblet has felt? That was the question asked by the poet. Then, before the potter gave you to the world. Before coming to the world, it has to undergo many twirlings, many tests. And after passing all these tests only, it will come out. Okay. So, what are the feelings of the goblet? The poet has asked the goblet. Okay. So, then what is the answer of this goblet? Let us see now in the second stanza. I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away from the great potter's hand that burned so warm. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. Once again, I read. I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away from the great potter's hand that burned so warm. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. So, actually, it hasn't felt happy to cast into the shape of the goblet. Okay. I felt a conscious impulse. Impulse means strong desire. Okay. Very strong desire it has got that time. What was that? To break away. It doesn't want to become the pot, the pot or any other form or goblet. Okay. It wanted to go back to the original form, that is clay form. Okay. From the great potter's hand that burned so warm. Because after making that, he will burn it. Okay. Just to get the hardness and all. So, he will burn it. So, that it doesn't want. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow. Yes, vast means very huge, very big sorrow. It felt very sad to be cast, to become into that form or to appear in that form, into my present form. So, to the present form, either goblet or any pottery, it doesn't want to become. So, it felt very sorry on the potter's wheel before forming into that strong desire it has got when it was in the form of a clay and when it was turning into the form of the goblet or the pottery. Okay. So, it doesn't want to become like that. Okay. So, that it expressed. Then, in the third stanza, before that fatal hour, fatal means actually death, leading to death. So, before that fatal hour, that saw me captive on the potter's wheel and cast into his crimson goblet sleep. Sleep I used to feel, the fragrant friendship of a little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. Okay. Before that fatal hour, before the death of my last feeling, because once it gets its full form and once it goes to the burning, then definitely that will not have the life once again. So, this is a fatal hour. Okay. That saw me captive on the potter's wheel. So, he has captivated. That means he has imprisoned that clay and the potter's wheel. Okay. He has caught it. Okay. So, it cannot go from that. Then, and cast into his crimson goblet sleep. So afterwards it will become into crimson color. Crimson color we can say dark red or bluish red like that. Okay, so that crimson goblet, what it felt? Sleep I used to feel. So it wanted to sleep. Where it wanted to sleep? The fragrant friendship of little flower. Actually it was the soil is with the pot, in the pot or in the soil itself. So the soil, when the soil is there, it was with a flower, a single flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. Actually bosom means surface, or here intimate, even intimate, very close friendship also we use the word bosom, and but here the surface. Okay, we can take into surface. So the fragrant friendship of a little flower, it has got a friendship that is sweet fragrance, the smell of a friendship that is with the little flower, and whose root was, the flower's root was in my bosom buried deep. Buried means very deep. Deeply it was buried. Okay, so very deep, very in depth it was there, and so that much that shows its intimacy with the flower. So that flower will give some fragrance, some sweet fragrance, some sweet smell. So that was very happy for this clay, but it doesn't want to become the goblet or the pot. Okay, then the fourth stanza, it expresses its views like this. The potter has drawn out the living breath of me. Yes, so the potter has drawn out the living breath of me. Actually it has got the life, but this potter has taken away the life of the soil and given me a form which is the death of me. But he has taken the life and gave it the death. So it has died. Once it was burnt, it became dyed. Then my past unshapely natural state was best. Actually it was it wanted to become as shapeless form, that is the red clay, the soil. Okay, so it liked that. So that was the best state it felt, with just one flower flaming through my breast. So only one flower was flaming. Flaming is just like the light it was. Okay, so only one flower was there on my breast. This breast is nothing but the bosom. Okay, bosom and breast are synonyms. Remember, breast means bosom. Okay, so on my breast, other than the chest, the only one flower was flaming. Okay, so I was very happy with that shapeless form, but not with this dyed form. Okay, this is the feeling of the tenth goblet. Thank you.